The Nintendo 3DS / DS and the Wii U are officially down with their online. It's officially dead. And I want to talk about the games that I played online, the memories that I have with different games that I did, different online things with these systems, despite the flaws I had with the Wii U, the issues I had. And the 3DS, I had so many amazing memories of online-related things, so let's just chat about it a bit. Now, the DS, the biggest thing I'm going to talk about first is Pokemon. You know, Pokemon in general has been in my life forever, since I was a kid. Like, a really young kid. Pokemon Diamond and Pearl, I used to go in the caves with my friends, I used to play online battling with them, we used to do trades. And let me talk about like the DS Pokemon games in general. Wonder trading was fantastic. It was awesome. You'd randomly get shiny Pokemon every now and then, you'd randomly get legendary Pokemon every now and then, even if they weren't like tradable or they weren't legal. It was kind of cool still to see those Pokemon get traded to you randomly if you did it enough. It was just kind of cool. Now, one thing I used to really remember as a kid in elementary school when I played my DS Lite was PictoChat. I don't know if PictoChat necessarily was online or if it was local, but that was a fun thing that I remember that I was fond of as a kid and thought it was really fun. Me and other kids would have our DS Lites or Nintendo DSs in general underneath like the desks at school, and we would just PictoChat each other just for fun, and I thought that was kind of just a neat feature that the DS had. Now, another huge one on the 3DS that I did play quite a bit online with friends or just in general was Animal Crossing New Leaf. This was way before New Horizons, and there was a lot you could do in this game, but I always was fond of being able to go to other friends' towns, them visiting your town, being able to give each other items, just exactly like New Horizons. And you could also do that, I think, with memory cards with the original GameCube version of Animal Crossing. But with New Leaf, those were some memories that I had, and I thought that was always just really cool that you could do that, you know? Like, back in the day, on the DS days, when you were a kid, like, it felt different than it does when you're an adult, because, you know, the internet, this is like just a normal thing now. But as a kid, when the DS came out and it started getting online and you could do these different things, it always just felt different, you know? It just, something about it as a kid, being able to like talk to your friend on the phone while you're trading with them or going to each other's towns or something like that, really mostly before social media, was always just something very special. So those are the games that I chose for the 3DS. I played a lot of single player games and mostly Pokemon, but I played a lot offline. But those were a few of the mentions that I wanted to mention when it came to online. Dragon Ball Z I didn't play a whole lot of, but Animal Crossing and Pokemon I played a ton of between online and everything else, and especially the Wonder Trading and the battling online with the older Pokemon games. Oh, also Mario Kart online? I mean, come on. Mario Kart 7 online was like awesome at the time. Being able to play online in handheld on this little handheld. Like, it was just fun, you know? I thought I was out of ideas, but then I realized I'm wearing a Mario Kart shirt. So Mario Kart 7 online absolutely was amazing at the time when it came out. It was like just so much fun. Well, I mean, you can't get enough of Mario Kart. I mean, we're kind of getting enough of Mario Kart 8. We need Mario Kart 9, please. But that being said, Mario Kart 7 was a banger. A lot of fun to play online on the DS. Now, onto the Wii U. The biggest title that I want to talk about more than any from the Wii U era was Splatoon. Splatoon was such a great new refreshing IP from Nintendo. This brand new first-person shooter, they wanted to get into the competitive scene of first-person shooters or third-person shooters because they were getting really popular at the time between Call of Duty and other ones, and they were like really big at the time, and they were slowly building up to becoming more popular. Nintendo wanted to get in on this, and having these Inkling characters, these squids that shot paint, and like you have to paint as much as you can on the field, plus there was like tower modes and different modes. Like, at the time when the first one came out, it was very special because it was refreshing, it was new, it was something different that we had never seen before. But it was so Nintendo like to do this, you know? It felt very Nintendo, if you know what I'm saying. And I remember playing this online like every single night. I was in high school when the Wii U came out, and when Splatoon came out, I was, I think, my junior or senior year of high school, and I remember I had my friend come over my senior year of high school all the time to play Splatoon, and there was a point in the tower battle mode where you had to secure the tower. He was just, what he was doing was cheating and just putting paint all over the map instead of focusing on the tower, trolling, and he won like 20 times in a row. It was ridiculous. I don't know. There was a lot of broken aspects about Splatoon 1, but the game still, like, was so amazing at its time, from the story mode with the characters and the gameplay and the enemies and the bosses to the online multiplayer at the time, and like how on the Wii U gamepad you could touch one of the players on the gamepad on where you wanted to be, was just so dang cool. And I think that Splatoon 1 is very underappreciated because it was in the Wii U era of Nintendo, but it expanded itself upon with Splatoon 2 and then 3, and I hope that the Splatoon franchise continues and broadens its horizons and we get even bigger, more refreshing new ideas with the Splatoon characters in the future. Now, this ain't a Wii U video, this ain't a Nintendo video, I should say, unless I mention Super Smash Bros. Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. It was on the 3DS too, I did not mention that. But the 3DS Wii U Smash 4, as we call it, well, I had a lot of very good memories with this game before the Switch was a thing with Smash Ultimate. I kept my Wii U waiting for a new Smash game because I played so much Smash 4. It was insane. Like, I had parties with this game, and like, the online wasn't very good, but it was still there, you know? It was still actively there until Smash Ultimate. And a lot of people were playing it. And I remember when Mewtwo got announced as DLC. That was exciting. And then we got Cloud in Smash with the Wii U version. And that was the craziest mind blower we never expected. And it really changed the scene for Smash in general and playing online. And it was just a ton of fun, you know, at the time. I mean, I don't miss it anymore because Smash Ultimate. But Smash 4 was a huge hit. Now, outside of those, and of course Mario Kart, but I'm not going to mention Mario Kart because it's on the Switch. It's the exact same game, just ended up getting DLC. There wasn't a whole lot in the Wii U era that I played. Maybe Zombie U? I think you could play two-player online with that. I don't really entirely remember. I didn't have a lot of crazy memories with the Wii U outside of those few titles. But I still appreciate what the Wii U did because it led us into the Nintendo Switch era. Same with the DS. They basically merged the two into one with the Nintendo Switch, which is amazing. And it was a super genius idea. But the Nintendo Online for the Wii U and DS is officially closed, officially done. I wanted to make this video to talk about it because I have a lot of memories with those, with their online, with their features. And it's something that I for sure will miss in some ways. I don't have a Wii U anymore because once the Switch got the games I wanted, I just kind of got rid of it because they started porting basically everything except Zelda. Please, Nintendo. Please. Still waiting. Except for that. But they gave me a lot with the 3DS for sure. And it's something that a lot of people will miss. So, thanks for the memories and thanks for watching. And I will see you guys next time. Feel free to check out the previous videos. They'll pop up. I don't know. Some cool stuff. Peace.